We're here, STG Weekly, number 17. It is the grand tale of them all, the tale of ALLTYNEX, by the doujin company Siter Skain. I don't know if it's pronounced like that, but...
Siter Skain.
Siter Skain.
Siter, okay. I like to say Siter because it sounds like spider. Sounds kind of badass. But so we actually got a pretty big commentary party today for the episode. Should be quite awesome, of course. Myself, I'm Aquilus, the host of SCG Weekly, along with my co-host, Frenetic.
Yeah, F-Man in the house. How's it going, SCG Weekly listeners?
We also got some other special guests, including AlphaProspector and Seon King from Nyu Media.
Hey guys, nice to be here. Thank you for having us.
Indeed.
Hello, hello. Thanks.
Hey guys.
This is Siter from Nyu Media, by the way.
Yeah, and this is AlphaProspector, by the way.
Yeah, thanks for it, because yeah, we got a lot of voices here. And then also, we are joined by Softdrink. He might be replacing a soda drink, our fellow streamer. He's not streaming for us today, so we got a Softdrink replacement. Hey, Softdrink. How's it going?
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Hi there. So we got all sorts of people related to the tale of ALLTYNEX going to talk about all about these games and stuff like that. I should probably be playing some of this footage here.
And also me, Aleksei.
Oh, Aleksei, sorry. Oh, man, we got so many
people. Last but not least, Aleksei.
Sorry, man. Like I say,
Don't forget of him.
Yeah, I'll be
talking a lot about the story if I can.
As we go along here. But yeah, so the Tale of ALLTYNEX, it is a series of three games. Kamui, RefleX, and ALLTYNEX Second. It's actually a trilogy, which is going to be released to the West from Nyu Media. And that's kind of why we got Seon here. Seon, do you want to talk about these upcoming releases?
Happy to. So, again, my name is Seon King from Nyu Media. Just a little bit of background on us. We're a UK-based company in London. We're not all Londoners, though, by any means. Basically, we're all spread around the world, different parts. And we've been working localizing Japanese indie games, doujin games, for just over the last year or so. And have released, I think it's, 9 games to date, 7 of which are on Steam, 2 of which are in Steam Greenlight, and we have the launch of the ALLTYNEX games coming up for the end of May. So this, obviously, is our latest release. It's 3 games that make up a trilogy, Kamui, RefleX, and ALLTYNEX Second, mm-hmm. by another awesome doujin development partner of ours called Siter Skain. They're basically a three-man development team that have been working on these games since 1999. AlphaProspector might correct me here.
That's correct. At least Kamui came out in 1999.
That's right. And they actually started earlier than that with the FM Towns version. Correct.
ALLTYNEX 1996.
Yeah. So ALLTYNEX Second is actually a remake of ALLTYNEX that came out in 96, wasn't that? So these guys have been at it for a while. They have some serious chops. They don't actually make video games for a living. They're involved in software, but this has purely been a hobby for these guys. And they've done an amazing job. You know, it's before we even formed Nyu Media, these games were on our radar, and it's something that we wanted to work with, these guys as a group. We really wanted to work with the series because if you like shoot 'em up games, you're going to like the ALLTYNEX games. It's pretty simple as that. And if you have any appreciation at all for 2D graphics in particular, 2D art, like old school arcade style gaming and art, then you're going to love it. Absolutely love it. So we first started talking to them maybe a year ago about this series. It's been a really busy year for us and for them, so it's taken a while for us to get to this stage. But a year ago, we got in touch with Jiruren, who is the representative for Siter Skain, and basically said, "You know, we love your games. We'd love to work together. Could we possibly collaborate to bring these out overseas. And basically, he was kind enough to say yes. I hadn't met the guy at the time, but we had a lot of correspondence. We put it in motion, and as of now, we finished. We've had the alpha builds. The full translation's been done. It's gone into the games. We've had the initial builds. We've provided feedback on that, and now we're working towards the beta version, and then we'll lock it to the final versions in time for release in May. In the meantime, excuse me, we have a pretty exciting announcement coming up about the series on Tuesday next week. That's April the 16th. And that's what's keeping us busy right now, as well as the translation. But can't say too much on that right now, but details will follow on Tuesday next week. So please keep an eye on our Facebook, our Twitter, our forums, Alpha Prospector's Twitter account, and sharing the news.
Yeah.
So I think that brings us up to date pretty much with where we're at with the ALLTYNEX series.
Okay, any great questions? Yeah, that's really cool. We're STG Weekly. We're really glad to pipe these games. I've played them a bit myself. I know we got a few of you guys that play these a lot more than I have, and more than Frenetic and I have. So it's gonna be really neat to learn a bit more about these games.
Yeah,
and
definitely.
And Aleksei, you mentioned that you want to talk about a bit about the story. So this will kind of be a preview of this localization almost, because I don't really know anything about the story. But in these localizations, we are going to be able to learn also a bit more. But Aleksei, you say you know some stuff about the story of this game, though, these games.
Yeah. Cool. Yeah, well, actually, when I started playing it 2 years ago, I posted on Shmupsworm that I wanted to know the story. And the Subterranean Sun posted a reply from something that he translated. So it's pretty accurate to the wiki that they have on the three games, and it expands a little more. So as we're watching the video, I'm going to say, oh, well, that's this part of the story, and so on.
Okay. Well, I suppose we can just, not much else to say, but we should probably get into the game, since we do have pretty much three full games to get to on the episode. It's going to be kind of long, so a lot of ALLTYNEX. It's just ALLTYNEX everywhere.
Yeah, this is going to be the epic tale of ALLTYNEX.
And it is epic. This has been quite some translation. You don't maybe see every aspect of the story in the games, but you see the stories being played out, and the actual stories themselves are pretty deep, and it's pretty kind of hard sci-fi in one sense. So yeah. We're looking forward to pushing this out. It has to be told.
Yeah.
Yes.
I think it's told. Yeah, the story is really good, and they connect the story in all three games really good as well.
Yeah, even just from not even knowing the story, like the presentation of the game too, kind of gives you this kind of feeling like, oh man, I'm probably getting into some shit.
Yeah.
Indeed. Hell, man, this is gonna be dark as fuck.
Yeah.
Yeah.
PG-13, where it is? Oh,
yeah. Yeah, right here. Rage. I've been on STG Weekly.
First F-bomb.
Mm-hmm.
Cast.
Okay. I'm sorry.
No, keep them coming.
Yeah, okay.
Indeed. All right. Well, I suppose we should get on to the Kamui replay. What do you guys want to, kind of preface Kamui with in terms of the gameplay mechanics and stuff before we get into the replay? I suppose anyone can
step
up on that.
I don't know anything about Kamui or RefleX, so I'm only here for a second.
Kamui often gets referenced to as Ray Force. So this is like a Taito game. Really kind of put Taito's series on the map, and much loved series. They had Ray Force, Ray Storm, Ray Crisis. It just kept going on and on and on. But when I played these other games, they're good, but Kamui kind of hits a special thing, and I think takes that 2D level of which makes unique to those Ray series games, that 2D level of the charge bolts, like it's right. A unique shmup experience.
It's also a little less annoying than Rayforce because of the lock-on lightning system.
It's auto-locking.
It covers the whole screen, so you're not running around the entire screen trying to lock onto the background target.
Right. Just to speak to the story for a moment, Kamui was actually the first game developed in the series, in the trilogy, in 99, but this is actually the last part of the story of the trilogy.
Oh, really?
The final chapter. Yeah.
So, in terms of the story chronology, it goes ALLTYNEX second, RefleX, Kamui. In terms of how they actually came out, was Kamui, RefleX, ALLTYNEX second. Oh, confused, wow. you will be. Just wait.
Yeah, it's a little confusing, but funny. Okay.
Yeah, we've already got people from the chat that says, Zayrock says, true sequel to Rayforce, better than Storm, in his opinion.
We have, actually this is about all of the games in the series, but we have a great quote from DJ Incompetent, from Atchmutz, and he said, Taito took the torch to their Lair section / Ray series, handed it to Siter Skain and said, hey man, you got this, lock-ons and homing lasers ahoy.
Wow. Got him.
Nice. Oh, let's go see this game, huh? Let's get into Kamui.
Alright, why don't we? Alright, guys, so I'll just do a countdown. 3, 2, 1, click. And on the click, that's when we'll watch the Kamui video. Alright, so I think we're ready then. 3, 2, 1, click.
Oh, look at this epic music.
And that launch sequence.
This is the orbital mechanized temple, which has been in orbit above the Earth for just centuries. It's been worshipped by people as a god, and it's been dormant the whole time, but now it's been activated to set in effect a chain of events that should destroy mankind. That's the idea. But in fact, the story doesn't quite turn out that way.
Yeah, so you see in the beginning, he immediately started locking onto the targets in the background. And he, when you watch the thunder bar, when you're holding down the exit, it fills it up all the way, so you can get the times 16 multiplier. If you just press it, one time, you get the times 16 multiplier, and you have to recharge it. If you don't recharge it, it'll do at a lesser and lesser value.
So at full charge, you get the X16.
Yeah.
Okay, gotcha.
And right here, he's letting that yellow target go into the background, so you can get that full 16 combo instead of just destroying it with a shot.
Okay.
So he's letting his thunder bar recharge totally before he does a lock on again.
Right.
Get that max 16 points or times 16 multiplier.
Yeah, if you want to score really well in this game, you definitely have to try to do as much as times 16.
So you get the shot, you get the lock on, and then what's the other one thing called? The breaker?
The shot, the lock on, and the I guess the thunder.
Thunder? Okay. Yeah. And that clears out bullets in your way.
It's like a shield.
Well, that's the lightning katana. I think that's the name, the official name.
It's kind of badass.
That's cool. Yeah.
Everything is badass in this game. I don't know, the boss warnings, the way the bosses attack, and deliver their payload. It's weird.
I like the bullets that come from the background.
If you notice, the game also focuses a lot on destructible parts or the different. You can target a lot of stuff on them.
Yeah.
Beat the shit out of them.
Yeah, he's doing the wings. He's doing the wings, and then he's gonna do the tail. In the background, but he has to be careful not to hit the body too quickly, or he won't get to hit those parts. And also those little mines coming out, he's targeting them too for a little
and
more
some
points.
Of these enemies also change the way they attack as you keep destroying them. That's rather nice.
Yeah, in this translated interview by Black Oak of the Dojin Circle, Jiraroon says he tried to implement multi-part professional-looking enemies and bosses like in Battle Garega, which is also known for a lot of destructible part bosses for bonuses and what. So if you guys like Battle Garega, Kamui's got some something for you too.
Yeah, you have plenty of that. You can slowly disarm the boss and keep racking up points.
Yeah, there's a little bit of milking that you can do, like those missiles that were coming out just a second ago.
Stage 2, right?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, this is that the music. World right? This was apparently the world record score at some point also. I don't know if it still is.
There are also a couple of scoring tricks you can do. For example, some mid-sized enemies, when you shoot them down, they go to the lower plane and you can target them with the lightning. That gives you more scores. That's a neat trick and very useful, and but a lot of people do in those replays.
Yeah, he's gonna do it here a lot by just shooting just a bit this plane that's coming up and then letting it go to the background.
To get the you can do that with bosses too.
Yeah.
That's pretty important. So yeah, Kamui has this action in two separate layers. You have the background layer and the foreground layer, and you have to shift through them using your weapons and pew 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 and all that stuff.
Yeah. I think this is just so unique to the genre too. It kind of took that Xavius thing where you have to bomb in the background, but kind of refined it into this form here.
More like an evolution, really cool. I would say.
I love this tank. Oh, look at that explosion. Oh.
Yeah, it's so awesome, everything. That is so much love, those enemies.
Yeah. And there's a short, there's also a short period of time where after you destroy one of the ships, that as they're being destroyed, you could also use your lock-on to get a multiplier on it.
Oh, cool.
Wow.
No idea.
We're getting a request for the sound to get turned up a little bit, about 10% more from Six Slit,
yeah,
from Dankotron.
I already did that. Thank
you,
though.
Cool.
So you said the whole team for this is three people. Does that include the art?
Fundamentally, yeah, they do everything. They don't outsource anything, but they do have other people join the team to provide support from time to time. Mostly it's been for help with modeling, based on what I've seen in the credits, but also for playtesting as well. But they do the art themselves for almost everything.
Yeah, that's
for
phenomenal.
Example, the music is done by Jiraroon himself. He did all the music, right?
Oh! Okay.
And the programming, design, everything.
Oh yes, yeah. And the story.
He's been favorably compared to another very famous doujin creator who does a lot of things himself. We won't mention
the Z word,
the unnamed one.
Yeah,
the unspoken rivalry, perhaps.
Yeah.
I'll go there. So, but one thing that's really immediately clear from Kamui is they just have an amazing sense for drama and presentation, and just how to make the game just look like it's got a lot of depth and a lot of action through using those different planes, using all the debris, and using the different angles and so on. We'll see more of those later. Like where the plane comes in and drops the tank just a bit earlier. I love stuff like that.
You see the craftsmanship in the enemy formations, bullet patterns, everything is so carefully taken care of.
But not only the patterns, but also look at the weapons hit and destroy, like just the sweet particle effects, you know?
Yeah.
Love that lightning katana hitting the body of the boss, and just like, look at those parts of the ship just breaking off. Wow.
We have just a bit of a profile on Siter Skain that we're going to be releasing soon. And they say that they focus in particular on just getting a sense of destruction into the games. But also the weapons mechanics, and we see that in each of the different games. They've got really tactical aspects to them, and fun score systems. So we see all those.
Yeah, very cool.
And that was music.
Yeah, great music.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I guess you could say. I mean, I have to make the comparison. I mean, with Zune and the Toho games, I mean, some of the scoring systems, they go so over the top, whereas these Siter Skain games really keep it simple. Like, it's a stark contrast, I think.
Yeah. It just goes to show how rich the doujin world is. And, you know, I'm a collector of arcade hardware. I've got 3 arcade cabinets in one of my bedrooms. But I'd still keep on coming to these PC doujin games. If you guys aren't playing these, you're missing out. I'm telling you.
Yeah, this is actually the second game I ever tried to ace, and the first one being Chōren Sha 68K. And so
that's great.
I started off really good, you know, PC doujin games with really great music.
This part clearly shows how the action goes on, where you have to switch between the thunder, the laser, the main gun. Have a lot of action going on. It's relentless, spectacular.
Yeah, this reminds me of like the third stage in shmups, where it's just like, all right, let me show you what we could really do. And so this is a really unique.
Yeah.
I like how you're like flying into the cave or two.
Yeah, you are going through technically waste disposal facility on your way to fulfill your mission. It's quite
that's poo on the side. You're shooting pieces of poo.
I have no idea.
For points.
I guess
technically the stage 3 boss is the waste disposal guardian. So yeah, he will dispose of you.
Taking out the trash.
Let's call it Ogumo. If you're interested.
Oh, Zither in the chat mentioned that some small enemies and missiles can drop items, so sometimes it's valuable to milk for shield extends.
Apparently. Usually the first shield extend comes after the first stage.
Just a minute.
Look at all this beautiful scaffolding. You can see like these, it came out in 1999, and you can see all these like citations from past maps. Like when I'm playing it, it feels like, oh, here's something from, you know, Raystorm, of course, Rayforce. And then here's something, oh, it feels like Raiden here. You know, I can look at the big bosses and the destruction craters that they leave on the ground. And yeah.
Actually, there's a point, and I think it's in this stage where It looks like a pattern from Rayforce, where like they have the same setup where the enemies against you, but I think in this game it's much cooler because the music and then the pacing of how you're destroying the enemies with the music fits all the way better. I'll point it out when it comes out.
Okay.
I think it's the next level.
And there's like 50 parts on this boss that you can hit with the
missiles. This is the first big first big obstacle for me, because you could get lots of points, like those mines right there, you could thunder those a lot and keep milking it, but you gotta have lots of endurance, because there's other parts later that get even more nerve-wracking in this boss.
Yeah, this boss is awesome.
Look at this.
Got you in there.
Yeah.
He really wants you dead and out of his stuff.
Dang, yeah. It's funky how he like flies over them when those missiles are coming from behind.
Yeah, you guys gotta like figure out which plane that the enemies are at, because you can actually move over them, you know. And
Just by the way, we hadn't mentioned yet, but one of the things we'll be adding to the English version of Kamui is Tate mode. So you'll be able to take a monitor and flip it 90 degrees, flip the game content, and play vertically. It's like
actually really cool. Standard. I'm glad you mentioned that.
Oh, oh my sweet. Gosh! Tate, yes! I'm going to throw this on my cabinet then. I'm going to throw this on my arcade cabinet and make a marquee for like Kamui. It's going in for a shmup meet.
For the record, everybody has AlphaProspector to thank for that, by the way.
The game even has an attract mode if you are interested. So, yeah.
Oh, cool. Right.
Yeah. Oh, look at that. Oh my gosh. And it goes to show you, like, it has this built-in scoring, like, desire for you to score, because if you just totally kill this boss, like, at the beginning, you don't get to see all these really neat parts.
Yeah, he didn't destroy, I think, some of the arms. I think he missed, like, one or two arms. He could have done that.
Okay, shit gets serious here.
Oh, the music is so cool.
Eternity. Are on your way to reach the neural nest. You will see.
I always like to see all those. You can destroy those mortises. There's another ray force thing. We have those ships in the background that you could target.
Yeah, I remember that ray force stage when they're like way back there.
Oh, I love the swell of the music.
Yeah.
Yep. The action of the enemies kind of follows the music. It's quite nice here.
This is the part that I was talking about. You have one enemy here, the other enemy there. And then he defeats him just in time.
Fucking awesome.
Wow.
Did I mention I love Kamui? Sorry, I just love it so much. It's so cool.
So is there any trick to getting a lock on and then using your lightning katana like right afterwards or anything to like get an X16 bonus like on an air enemy as well? Like, is there any like kind of like timings like that?
Well, I mentioned earlier that if you use your thunder first and then you let go of your lightning, it'll be at time 16, and if that enemy does go into the background as it's getting destroyed, you do get a hit on it.
Okay,
and now here, you're like fighting Kamuis, but they're not real Kamuis, because these are actually, you can see they're grayed out, they're mass production Kamuis. For it to be a true Kamui, you have to infuse a person with paranormal activities, their brain, into the ship, and
it's called the Sophical Theory Brain Fusion Technology.
Oh,
right. And so there's actually only 8 Kamui ships, and the ship that you're piloting is number 2.
Wow, just I didn't realize they were called Kamuis.
So, it turns out the story is that there was a guy called Professor Zafiko who invented this brain fusion theory, and
Isn't it Dr. Alice D?
Alice D, no. It's Professor... Alistair Panafield Zafiko, no, Professor Zafiko, anyway. And, honest, believe me, and invents this brain fusion theory, which is a way to weaponize psychics by transplanting their brains into Kamui ships, in this case. And it turns out that as he's doing this work, his own daughter is discovered to have these psychic powers, so the military march her away to be weaponized, so, and have her brain taken out and put into a Kamui ship. And it turns out that they basically coerce him to do it, so he has to do this to his own daughter. And it drives him insane in the process, and he basically swears vengeance upon the whole of humanity. And am I giving too much away here? I don't think so. And makes this system, which is basically what's hanging out in outer space and becomes the final boss, which is poised to destroy mankind. At the beginning of the game, the Kamui ship containing his daughter's brain, his daughter's name is Panafil de Alice, takes off, but it turns out that rather than going ahead and activating this weapon to destroy mankind, she ends up going to save mankind. And the reason is, as Zafiko put Alice's brain into the craft, he decided to let her retain consciousness, which had never been done to any of the brains before. So she's kind of like this ultimate fighting craft, but has a human conscience.
Damn.
And that is what the intro is about as well.
Whoa.
Wow.
That's very
not a great
cool.
explanation, but I hope that made sense.
That's amazing.
From
story.
I was reading, they have slightly different names, but yeah, those are the names. And then one more thing is that he infuses himself into the judge, which is the final boss that you fight after the ALLTYNEX.
I try to hold something back there, but it turns out this giant device that's poised to destroy mankind is actually him. He's transformed himself into this huge weapon. And we've actually translated it as adjudicator, which is in keeping with some of the existing English stuff.
Wow.
Oh.
Oh yeah. Now shit gets serious, yeah.
So it's the age-old story of, you know, man has daughter, man puts daughter's brain into a ship, man tries to destroy mankind, daughter goes to destroy him, kills her dad. Oops, sorry. Yeah, that is.
Man.
It's repeated. It's only down in the centuries.
It just keeps happening. Enemy after enemy type of thing.
So now he's coming up to the ALLTYNEX OS, and you could do a lot of milking on this boss.
So just for the Puritans out there, fellow Puritans out there, this is ALLTYNEX OS-based system, but it's not actually the ALLTYNEX computer itself. It's the neural nest, which is based on the ALLTYNEX OS, which was destroyed in ALLTYNEX II, which happened, of course, centuries before Kamui.
Okay.
Right, and you see this boss in ALLTYNEX II as well.
Yeah, you know, one thing that I'm noticing looking through here is that a lot of these bosses show up in one form or another. I think it was the Stage 2 boss is also in ALLTYNEX II. So it's kind of cool. It's a lot like the Dodonpachi series in that it seems kind of self-referential. You know, it tosses in these nods to the other games in the series. Which is always nice to see, I think.
just showing off that missile.
You can just spam the thunder into the background to get rid of this boss quickly, but he's trying to take out both arms at the highest multiplier.
So he's okay, trying to weaken them evenly,
or and get the highest multiplier while doing that. Yeah, you saw it said times 16.
Yeah.
If you just spam the background thunder, it'll release like one ray of thunder at a time really quickly. It'll be at the lowest multiplier.
Oh, right. Yeah, no bonus then, of course.
And here you could do this for a while. The boss does time out. If you just keep it destroying these little hexagonal shapes or whatever they are, but you want to make sure you get the times 16 for the actual core.
Okay. So I assume like the big pieces are worth more than smaller enemies.
Yeah.
I would assume X16 is worth it more.
Yeah. Well, like in the first stage, you could do the math. Like there were little ships coming out of the carrier ships. If you target like, I think six of them, it'll actually be a little more for getting than just getting the ship by itself. So it's in your interest to let the ships come out instead of just spamming it with thunder. But the way he did it on the first stage, that's probably the best way to do it.
Yeah, this is making easy work of this guy right now. Those Taito lasers, the Rayforce lasers, get you. Oh, that was cool. Did it just time out, or did he actually kill it?
I didn't see the time 16.
I think it timed out. Can't really get a high uptime on that operating system.
Oh, Zither says he did get the X16.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah, he said he saw it pop up.
My joke.
So. I love these epic title screens. You can say, like, warning, boss, approach it.
I'm suggesting every dev to add that. I love that kind of warnings.
Yeah. I love seeing that, you know.
It's like, yeah, target the big fucking machine, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, shoot the core, you know, I love that.
I like the ones like in Espigaluda. They have, like, at the stage transitions, they just have, like, a wall of English text.
oh, yeah, I love that. Stage one, it kind of explains what's going on. I was playing that today because I just got the PCB again after a while. And yeah, it has all this English and it has a nice background and there's like food in the middle and you're like, what is that food? you know, people ask about like what it is, and the guy's like, I think it's curry. So that flavor, it just adds to the drama of the game, you know. People say that shmups don't have a narrative, but I think people read it ahead of time and they play out the drama as it goes in, as they play the game. You know, it doesn't necessarily have to be, you know, just integrated in cutscenes or whatnot, but just a little bit goes a long way.
Yeah.
So he's trying to get the multipliers for each of the wings. Now he has one wing left, and you know, he's destroying the ships, and the ships that come out from the background, it's always good to be at the top of the screen for that. And right now, it's the way he attacks the boss is probably the best way, because he makes it go into the background, so he has a little, you know, moment to breathe and get into a good position so that he can get those multipliers.
That's why he destroyed the front parts.
Yeah, because if you don't destroy them, there's going to be the laser that you can't block with your thunder.
Yeah.
Mm.
I see. Man, getting all the strategies in this video.
Oh, yeah. Oh, he goes right up in the middle. Same spot.
What was he intercepting there? Were those missiles?
Yeah.
Oh, no, those are ships. They come from the back of the judge. Yeah, you notice in the beginning of the fight that they came out, and he was at the top of the screen then too.
Oh, I didn't see that. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Also, what he does is, as you can see, like each part of the ship that it's being destroyed, it forces it into the background for a little bit, just to highlight that to some of the other viewers that that's when it goes into the background in the second plane. More ship destroying in the back. He moves this safe spot.
Yeah. After he destroys all these parts, there's going to be more, like a bunch more bullets on the screen. And this is where there are these like smiley faced lasers that go down on you. They're not blockable with the thunder either.
I always get a lot of smiley faces when I got gone down upon in my time. Yeah, the F-Man's in the house! I'll be bringing back memories.
They look more like Pringles to me. Those are Pringles.
Yeah.
Those are green licorice. So yeah, I guess like this guy's on his last shield right now, last life. So
yeah,
kind of makes it
yeah
fun.
He's taking it to the. Look at all those smiley faces. Oh, by the way, fellas, yeah, if you're going down, you got to have a smiley face too. Can't be having a frown. Take some tips from the F-Man here. Not only are you using shooting tips, but also love tips here on the SG Weekly.
yeah.
Oh, dang! This is the clutch right here. It's like, do I scrap this run? Do I keep on going forward? No shield.
When I first saw this replay, I thought that he purposely did that to lower rank, but then I thought, there's no rank in this game, so...
It did kind of look like earlier he got hit on purpose, but hey, who knows? Maybe he's just playing it up.
Oh, shiz! Gotta love that lightning katana. Oh, that was hairy. What?
Were there attacks like that in Rayforce? So like just targets that came down and like laser blasts like that?
I don't remember.
I know I've seen it in other games though. Actually, Ginga Force, yeah, there's a boss that has an attack just like that.
Which the boss, the final boss?
I think it was something.
Oh dang!
Mission complete. It says that.
Do the victory.
Oh yeah, you got to get up in that explosion and move around.
Do the victory jiggle.
Press A for awesome.
The victory wiggle. I've done the victory wiggle. You got to do it.
Yeah. You got to do it, guys.
Alright, so basically my mind was blown.
Yeah.
By that crazy Akira-like story and... Damn.
Yeah. It reminds me of Battle Angel Alita, aka Gunnum, you know?
Oh,
like,
whoa, there she is.
Oh! Hello, Alice. She's also in that outfit, like, through the looking glass. Alice in Wonderland.
Is that like a photograph of the scene? The Tale of ALLTYNEX.
You don't miss the game. That's
that image is in the opening scene as well. Oh, before you start the game.
gotta get it started.
Banana matting.
Oh god damn it.
Just to let you know.
Apparently it's a day one buy because of that. Alright. Erhune.
Hey Erhune. Yeah, shout out to Erhune. He's one of the French guys that actually, he has a blog where he has attended many of the cave Matsuri in Japan. So, a little background on Erhune. I think he knows Prometheus as well. He's probably going to be at Washoi in Europe, a gathering of Japanese super players at the Rens Festival at Stunfest. So, Just a little background on that. So many thanks, Erhoon.
All right. Well, Kamui's pretty cool. Anything else to say about Kamui before we move on to Reflex? We're going to check it out. Not, moving on to the Reflex here.
Oh, yeah. Did someone just take a little pee-pee break?
Apparently there's nothing left to say.
That's right. Taking out the waste disposal right there.
Flushing out the news.
I didn't think anyone could hear that.
Yeah, the comedy, man. The party comedy. Alright.
He just got way too excited. That last picture.
Yeah, the picture at the end just had to go.
It was potty time.
Did you go rub one out real quick?
Yeah, potty time.
Oh my god. Okay, I can't even continue. I'm not even doing it right. Okay, reflex.
So,
alright, what do we got to say about Reflex?
Well, second game in the series. This one came out. ALphaProspector, help me out here. When did this one come out? It must have been 2004 or 5?
2010.
Which one? Wait. RefleX, you mean?
RefleX?
Yeah, RefleX.
Oh. Yeah. Let me check the box. I have it right here.
While he's looking for that.
2008. August 2008.
Eight. Wow, way off.
Yep.
Okay, it's so there's a big gap.
Yep. Yep, 2008.
And I mentioned earlier that all the games have these different mechanics when it comes to the weapons, And RefleX has got one of the more standout kind of unique sense, I think, of the weapon. So Kamui was about the laser katana and targeted thunder attack. And RefleX is about the shield technology that's been developed, which allows the ship to reflect enemies' attacks. So what it does is completely defend the ship, and at the same time it rebounds the attack, so it changes the color, and that's used to score multipliers and attack other enemies pretty effectively. Mm-hmm. It's also got, definitely the deepest story of the three games.
Yeah, the longest.
Yeah, for sure. It's
the space opera of the ALLTYNEX series.
It is. So, just to lay it up, after the events of ALLTYNEX 2nd, which is the third game in the series, but of course happens before, RefleX in the timeline, Earth has been resettled, and they've kind of come back to prosperity again. All of the Earth's nations have formed a global united nation and a militaristic government, which ends up oppressing all the people around the world. In response to this, a resistance organization called ALLTYNEX comes up, and the backdrop for the beginning of the game is this global civil war, I guess, between the Global Unified Army and ALLTYNEX. So the ship at that point is part of ALLTYNEX, and they are attacked by some of the Global Unified Army on their way to the moon, for reasons which will become clear later. I can jump in with some story comments as the gameplay goes on.
Okay. By the way, if you download the free demo that's available, that's where the story ends.
Yep, it ends at the moon. Yeah.
Right. Which is where the next big twist in the story, first big twist in the story happens.
I'm not going to blow it this time.
Don't blow it, man. Don't blow it.
Feel free to make the call when it happens, just in case I'm not around at the time.
All right. So you guys talked about the shield and the life bar. Did you talk about the life bar thingy?
Oh well, as soon as your shield is depleted, you can get hit by the enemies, lasers or missiles, and running into them as well.
Mm-hmm. And is there anything that breaks through the shield?
The missiles
all the time.
Oh, missiles. The missiles do, okay.
Yeah, they're so annoying. All
right.
You can also get rammed by enemies.
Yeah, even with your shield.
And what's the scoring system in this game like?
You definitely want to build your multiplier up, just like in Kamui, and reflect by reflecting the bullets and keeping your chain going. By destroying enemies.
All right, so you reflect bullets to start a chain, and then you just keep on killing enemies while the chain's going. Is that basically?
Well, the chain can start just by you simply destroying with your forward shot.
Okay.
But lots of times to get the highest multiplier, and not break the chain. Which you see a little bar in the top right corner going down. That's your chain meter.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah.
Thank God it's not on patchy, don't worry.
Yeah.
Okay. There are no stage long chains.
So yeah, reflex stuff and then you get higher multipliers and it's fun
and
times.
64 is the highest multiplier on this one, I think.
I don't know, yeah, that high. Damn. That's really cool. Alright, well, I guess that's pretty much the basics of reflex, so I'm pretty sure we can get into our replay then. I'm going to need just probably just a 30 seconds here to set that up.
It was mentioned that the lasers get reflected, but you'll see that there's red and purple ones, shots and lasers that don't get reflected.
Okay, they just go through?
No, you just absorb them.
Oh, okay. I see. Gotcha. Okay. All right. All right, well, I think I'm ready to start the reflex, the second game of the Tales of ALLTYNEX, but not story-wise. All right.
Story-wise, it's the second, too.
Right.
Yeah, it's the middle one.
Yeah. Mm. All right, I'll do the countdown then. 3, 2, 1, okay. Click. from 3608, remember, everyone?
Yeah, 3608. Guys, cue it up.
All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1, click.
Here we go. We had a little bit. Erhun comes back.
Is it him again?
Well, at least those high scores were listed as Erhun, like at 3607, so.
Yeah.
Okay. I assume so? Yeah.
Yeah, so you see him using the laser and reflecting the shots, and it goes up to 64.
And I guess, like, yeah, it's being recorded from, like, a camera of some sort. I noticed that the screen's, like, moving around a bit.
Pice! How about you guys? What are your signs? I'm a gem.
Capricorn.
Yeah? How about you? Anyone else? Anyone else?
I'm Libra, which is actually the last boss.
Oh, hey! There you go.
I'm Aries.
Oh, okay.
I only learned what my sign was so I could put it in Gradius' game.
There you go. How about your blood type? Did you get that too?
Well, I know what my blood type is. Was that in a Parodius or something?
Yeah, I think so. I think in one of the other Konami games.
Maybe, Konami trolling it up.
So if you guys like like Giga Wang series, you got a little reflective.
Yeah, I like.
Yeah.
Whoa, dang! He's got X64.
All day.
Oh, no, not anymore.
That bloody Giga Wing shield.
Oh right, yes. Okay, yeah. That's why you mentioned Giga Wing, because it's got the reflector shield, right? And Mars Matrix similarly. Oh, another reflect. They call them reflect 'em ups. when it's like the main mechanic is reflecting.
Look at those heart-shaped bullet patterns. Come on, guys, get on this first botch, Virgo. And pop a chair.
The music is awesome.
Yeah, for people watching the stream, let me know if you want the music a little bit louder. I could turn up a little bit more.
Don't you wish you had a walk?
Oh, man. On that note, we will be releasing the soundtracks for the games as well. All three of the games.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah.
You heard it here on STG Weekly. Soundtracks are going to be released too. So I know the viewers out there love soundtracks. So get in on this.
Were there official soundtrack releases for these games?
There were. Reflex soundtrack contained Reflex, Kamui, and the FM Towns versions. Songs as well, if I remember correctly, and ALLTYNEX second, full ALLTYNEX second soundtrack in one disc.
Okay. I like the reflect noise of the bullets. A little, like, kind of beepy sound. Sounds silly. Okay, I'm gonna turn up
the music. You can also see that he's. Your forward shot can get rid of the purple shots, but not the purple lasers.
You said there's destructible shots?
Yeah, the purple shots that they shoot at you, you could get rid of them with your shot.
Okay. If
you see a purple laser, you can't get rid of that with your shot.
Okay, guys, I'm reading. According to Kotaku, this is like Ikaruga. What the hell?
It is. I guess you are reflecting some bullets here and there. And you did that in Ikaruga. I guess that's where they got that.
Well, it's a shoot 'em up, right? Yeah, and it's all artsy, foxy, blah 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 blah. What the fuck?
Oh, Ikaruga. Definitely gonna have to hit that game up for the STG Weekly at some point.
Oh yeah, that'll be cool. I'm a fan of that game, actually. You know, I like it. I recognize that there's a lot of things that a lot of people don't like about it, and I can understand that, but I'm a really big fan of it, so. Yeah,
I'm a fan of that, too.
I think Reflex should be played before Ikaruga if you're a beginner.
Yes.
As training.
Well, that was kind of cool.
Nice. Got both the
always nice on battle tanks.
Oh, dang.
Yeah, this is like the first time that you see the like a big laser block. And later on, you're gonna see that you can reflect their laser back onto them to deal damage.
Whoa!
So I'm assuming there's some like crazy like story background and about the reflecting like capability.
Actually, from what I read, it just said that it was developed. Someone else knows more about the. They just called it the shield shot system.
Okay.
It was developed by Professor Dennis, that's his surname, who was the pilot in ALLTYNEX Second. And it's based off research into one of... And tell me if I lose you here. Based into research into what was called the Zodiac Ophuscus core, which was a weapon that was created to destroy, to hunt down and destroy 12 other Zodiac weapons, which aren't the ones that have appeared in the game so far. They actually appear in the game later. So there are actually two sets of Zodiac weapons. The first one is the originals, which are just these apocalyptic living devices which are sentient and have these cores that allow them to sort of mutate their bodies, and they're just killing machines, huge killing machines. There's 12 of them. So this Ophuscus core was created to hunt these down and kill them. And the other set of Zodiac devices was created by Earth's forces, based upon some information they had about those kind of original monstrous ones. So the ones that we see early in this game here are the Earth versions, which are kind of like the weaker imitations. And then later on in the game, you'll see the real things actually come.
The real deal. Yeah.
So, yeah, to answer your question, it's based upon the Ophuscus Core technology, which was researched by the pilot in ALLTYNEX Second. Actually, on that note, the Ophuscus core is the core itself of the ship is actually what's inside the pilot ship, the ship that you pilot in Reflex.
Gotcha.
And that has a pretty big bearing on the story later on.
Don't you like this boss? How many attacks it has, the weapons it fires, how it moves, etc., 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 and how in the background you can see how you are ascending to Earth's orbit. That kind of neat stuff. I love.
Yeah.
You can see the moon starts showing up as you keep beating up Scorpio.
Yeah, so this is the Scorpio from Kamui, which you fought when ALLTYNEX projected it.
Oh, crash and burn, motherfucker.
Dog bitch. PG-13.
Oh yeah, so Aleksei said the audio cut out during this part, so yeah, we'll just be talking.
And the music in this level is actually very dramatic. It builds.
It's the longest track in the soundtrack.
Yeah, and it builds up the most when you're about to attack head on those the background ships. After you pass this laser, it's just really intense, and it's like the best part of the game, in my opinion.
Yeah, so you know, you got a reason to pick up these games when they come out.
Yeah, they're having the soundtracks and all that good stuff.
Yeah,
but that reminds me. Really, I have a question about how you guys are going about translating things. Like when you have things like the boss warnings, like are you translating those as well, or are you leaving them original?
It's really dependent on the game. So okay. In Kamui, the kanji and the kind of iconography of the Japanese characters is really part of the character of the game.
Yeah.
So when the boss warnings come out, it's basically the format is sort of location, description of the boss's name as it's spelt, and then big kanji of the actual boss's name.
We love that kanji.
Absolutely. So we of course had to keep that in. So everything else is English above the kanji, but you'll get your big block kanji to let you know exactly who you're going to be fighting.
Yeah.
We love our freaking kanji.
No, that's awesome. Yeah.
Yeah. You can G.
Conversely, Alternate Second is pretty much all in English. As presented anyway, so.
Okay.
I like this part because the background ship is firing you from the background, so you have to keep an eye on that. And then you have missiles and lasers. So you shoot the missiles so they don't get past your shield, and you block the lasers in the background.
Wow.
And you're just kind of like floating around too, which is kind of weird.
So what's happened here is the ship was attacked at the beginning of the game. It kind of flew down to Earth to access a passage into space to escape the atmosphere. So that was the whole of the last fight, going through that passage and out of the atmosphere. Now having exited the passage, the ships run into this huge fleet, the Meteor Fleet, which is owned by Earth's global United Army. So what it's doing is just basically running through the fleet here and trying to break through them.
The main objective still is get to the moon. Yeah. And you will see what happens there.
It's a lot more dramatic with the music and the sound effects, obviously.
Yeah, I really wish I could hear like what that would be like. Should have the orchestra. So.
By the way, in Comic Kit 80, there was a release of a booklet called The Tales of ALLTYNEX. I think it has all three of the stories in them. Did you guys use that for the translation at all?
Absolutely. It was a pretty important piece of information to have. We're looking at doing something with that too.
Ooh,
who knows? Awesome. Maybe that'll be included in the announcement on Tuesday.
Ooh!
I guessed it.
Stay tuned, guys. Very important announcement. I think you guys would be totally into it.
Warning. Gemini
or
type.
Yeah, Gemini.
So oh yeah, this is my sign.
So you have the red and the blue, the left and the right, and so one of them is the shield, and the other one is the attack. So you see it reflects right there.
His oh my attack. Gosh! So he's reflecting the guy's laser to kill its other twin, huh?
Right.
That's cool.
Whoa! Look, that's so sick.
That's RefleX right here. Bitch.
Yeah. So hardcore.
Yeah, this guy got it.
Insert
like
one liner. It's really nice. The design is based on a spear and a shield. Quite cool. Lots of pew pew. And you will see the big body.
just reflected its own caution. Oh yeah, I'll add some music. Do 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 do.
Boom.
Does the sound ever come back on? Just out of interest.
I don't. Yeah. Does it come back? I don't know.
It does at the end of the stage, unfortunately.
Okay, just the stage.
Yeah. I'd call that fortunate. It's all right. It's
good. The stage is epic, though. It just goes on, and you're like, fuck. How many battleships are there? How big is this fleet?
It's the fucking meteor fleet. Yeah.
Yeah. It's so cute. It gives you the sense of that, like, just how... just one ship against all these other ships, and you're just like, yeah.
Well, yeah, it feels like you're part of the big battle type of thing.
Yeah. Mm.
And then at the end, the bridge gets destroyed really quickly, but the trick is not to destroy it really quickly. And I'll point out what could have been done.
What's kind of cool about this is that it's kind of an inversion of the first stage of ALLTYNEX second, because there you're just one ship being launched from this enormous fleet of battleships, and you get to watch as all of your comrades get destroyed as you're heading towards the boss. So it's kind of cool to see it go in just such a radically different direction here.
Okay, so here, instead of just getting rid of the bridge, what I do is one of the little turrets that fire at you, I keep them alive and reflect those bolts to get the multiplier.
Gotcha. Alright, and the stage boss. Damn, that background. It's like Nebula's Ahoy.
You broke their toys.
Yeah, I think you're like in another warp speed or something.
Hyperspeed into the moon. Yeah.
Yeah.
To the moon. So what's going on at the moon? Like, what's the thing with the moon? Did we know?
There is a moon base over there.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
On this part, those missiles that go up at you, they first scared me, but then I realized that you could just reflect the lasers onto the missiles to get rid of them.
Ooh. Yeah. When in doubt, reflect. I like how the pacing just from that slow battleship movement, and it's like, all right, warp speed. Here we go.
I forget, but there's the multiple difficulties in these games too, right? I forget if there was...
Yeah, there are. I don't know about these two, but there's definitely different difficulty settings in ALLTYNEX second.
It has the sort of reward for failure, sort of you win a continue every time you die mechanic, which makes it easier as you go for people like me.
Yeah, that's that's the best way to do it, I think, for like the PC console side of things when it's not arcade. Oh yeah, the guy with the arms.
Oh dang, he's gonna cut you up.
Yeah, it seems unnecessary.
He wants you dead, that's the thing.
So this is cancer, right?
Yep. I think they added arms there so you couldn't get right in the middle and just stay there in the middle.
Mm-hmm.
Then it also kind of looks like crab.
Yeah. Crack that right. Crab.
Well, I mean, like, they put it like right there in front instead of like on the sides.
Yeah.
So you couldn't get right into the front.
I love crack crab. so delicious. There's this place next to my house where you can just get fresh, you pick out a crab and they steam it for you, and you can look at the live crab before you pick it to get eaten. They serve it with like melted butter and lemon wedges. So good.
That sounds good. I hate cracking crabs apart though. That whole messy, juicy.
Oh man, you gotta love the juice.
By the just in case someone's not familiar with this idea that each of the bosses actually are the symbol, the astrological symbol of what they are.
Mm.
Yeah. So Cancer is actually a crab, you know, by its symbol.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I was referencing. But yeah.
That makes sense.
Just like Gemini was the twins and so on.
Man, that's cool. That's neat that they took the idea that far. Yeah, the bullet hell pattern.
Yeah, this part's pretty tricky because if you hold your shield too long, you won't be able to reflect those bullets.
Right. Actually slow down there too.
Yeah.
Sorry, I was whistling.
Sorry.
Was that the laser? Because I think I might be out of sync here.
That was the laser. We
So that's the end of the demo if you played the demo. And now the real story begins.
We got music back.
Oh, music.
Oh, yeah, music.
Oh, yeah, the music.
It really does add a lot.
Pump that up.
Fire up the boss cannon.
Yeah.
So, what just happened there was, all of the game up until that point was about you fighting as part of the resistance against the global unified army of Earth. As you were fighting that last boss, what happened was, basically an alien invasion started. And the aliens came and just blew away the boss that you were fighting. Also blew away the moon base that you were headed to. And picks up from there.
My moon! You don't do that to my moon!
Don't do that to the moon! Oh yeah.
Yeah, I like this. I like this because now, like, the reflect mechanic is just taking out everything a lot of the time. For some reason, the reflect mechanic is like satisfying. Like all you're doing is reflecting bullets, but it's like, hey. I think I guess it's just the idea of like, hey, screw you, man. Take your. Have some of your own medicine type of thing.
Yeah.
That's like what it's based off of.
This is one of my favorite parts as well, because you're taking out these guys in pairs, and the music is really menacing.
These guys are Enropi, who are a squadron of fortress busters.
And you definitely don't want to get rid of them right away, because such that you give them a multiplier.
See what? Yeah. Okay. So you got X4 on that one to reflect. Just wait.
There's a way to get 64 on both of the first ones.
Oh wow. Yeah, when I was playing this, it looked like it was really like important to like wait for the right moment to reflect.
It is
to get like the good bonuses, and you know that really just takes familiarity to kind of figure when is the best time to reflect. Just cool. It's like, keep on playing it, you kind of figure it out a bit more, get better bonuses.
Basically, the tracking lasers and the tracking balls are the strongest reflecting things.
Oh, okay.
Okay, let's talk about the flavor. As you notice, the screen starts getting red as you keep pummeling these guys. That's because you are descending to Earth, right? Kind of obvious, but well. It's a nice little touch. I love that kind of stuff in the Siter Skain games. They all have those little touches and things here and there.
By the way, when they're at the bottom of the screen, you can actually go under the enemy without losing a shield and shoot at them.
Okay. Yeah, I love just how red it gets.
Yeah, shit gets serious.
Yeah.
Every now and then I see like shmups that have a part in the game where like the whole screen kinda is affected in some way, and it's usually pretty cool. Like I can think of like in Dragon Spear there's like a dark stage and you have to get like these flashlight power-ups to actually see in the stage, and I don't know, I like this too, where it's just like you're just caught up in it and you gotta deal with it. Like the red is kind of melting with the bullets a little bit.
That part with the lasers, I sweep from left to right to avoid the missiles.
Okay.
You kind of just stay to the left, but it's really easy just to start to the left and go all the way to the right and go back to the left.
I hope you guys noticed that the ship design changed to reflect. These are not the human armies. These are the new enemy, the aliens.
Yeah.
Small little details, as usual. We don't care, we shoot them down. We kill them all.
Yeah.
Well, that section right there totally reminded me of the intro to the fourth stage of Ikaruga, actually. With the two ships coming in from either side. On top and bottom. It's kind of cool.
So the enemy is called Raywat, I think. Right?
Yep. Raywat.
So they were humans who centuries ago ventured out into space and then they came back to reclaim Earth.
Actually, I believe that's the other way around. Well, basically, right. So humans, it turns out, are descended from Raywats. Raywats are the original kind of human people out in space. And they created the Zodiac devices, which was a huge mistake because they just go on a rampage and start killing everybody. They also created the Ephusus Core as a way to hunt down and kill down the Zodiac devices. But a group of Raywats who called themselves the Yuda Clan basically took the Ephusus Core, stole all of the data about the Zodiacs and just went off into space and disappeared. So that left the Raywats with these 12 Zodiac devices to try and shut down somehow. And they did manage it, but basically it destroyed their planet's ecostructure, destroyed millions and millions of them, and because of the kind of radioactive mess that their planet became, they mutated into basically dog-headed humans is what the outcome was. So they managed to get past this huge problem with the Zodiac devices, but they want to avenge themselves upon the people who took away the Ephusus Core and basically ended up getting them all, lots of people killed and having them mutated into these wolfmen, basically. So millennia have passed, and finally the Raywats have found out where these people are. They've been on Earth because when these Yuda people
went away with the Effusus Corps, they went to Earth and settled Earth as the humans, basically. So they've come now to avenge themselves on the descendants of the Nuda clan by wiping out the Earth, which is their plan. And to do that, they've reactivated the old Zodiac devices, and they now have them attacking the Earth. And that's basically the bosses we take on. Most of them are these now alien original Zodiac devices.
That's quite a background.
Yeah, I'm so glad we have Sion on, because I'm getting my information from someone who just looked at the menus and translated the best they could.
He did a great job, by the way. I saw his website, and it's mostly spot on.
Yeah.
Oh, this boss is cool.
Nice.
Yeah, it took me a while to figure out that you have to go around or your shield will deplete.
Oh. Man.
Oh, yeah, well, will you be able to use the arcade stick with all the games?
Yes, that's another improvement we've made for the English version. It uses X-Pad, and basically works with controllers, works with the Xbox controller, including the D-Pad now.
Ooh.
Oh, sorry, all three of them, that is.
Oh, excellent. Yeah, that was a question from the chat. Thanks for noticing that. Alright, got him.
That was the first boss you defeated there.
Yeah, that's Virgo.
Virgo, yeah.
So now, that's the human Virgo. So now you're sided with humans, the global armies. The Earth's race has united the Resistance and the global United Army, and now trying to fight against these Iwan.
I think what's happening with that camera is it's got like some type of auto adjust. And when there's like weird perspectives, it's like doing some weird stuff. Yeah, it's pretty funny.
Yeah, you know, when I uploaded that video, YouTube said, "Do you want to for us to make some auto adjustments?" And I said, "Yeah." And I guess these are the adjustments.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh my god. It's not the guy's camera? What the hell?
No, it was perfect, but YouTube messed it up.
What the hell, man? What the hell, YouTube? Dude, this is like Drunko Vision from YouTube.
Drunko Vision, oh my god.
This guy looks cool. Oh yeah, he gets you in the... Yeah, you can't move in there. Forgot about that. How you do it. Oh yeah, and then the force field. When I first was playing this, I was like, my shot's gonna get me or what? It's like, hey, they're reflecting, he's reflecting it now.
It's fun to ram your shield against the enemy shield. Because it makes a really, covers the screen with light, a lot of light. on here, it's good to go from just sweep from left to right as fast as you can. You see the bullets are coming in faster and faster.
Oh, got rammed.
This is the last Zodiac Virgo.
Okay.
Which is pretty mean.
Game over, man. Game over.
The ship's actually being held by a tractor beam here, so you can't actually move as a player.
What?
Game over.
So what just happened was ship got pummeled by a Libra.
Psych.
Just as the pilot was about to die, actually, sorry, just as the pilot died, the fuselage core inside the ship awakens, and the ship manifests these energy wings, which you've also seen on the alien Zodiac devices as well. So now your core, which was the original Zodiac killer, has woken up, and now your ship's powered up and you've become pretty badass, and it's time to go out.
Phoenix of Fucus.
Take it back to him.
I just love this part. It's so good done.
Oh, if you get hit, you don't have any shields in reserve, so it'll be game over.
Oh yeah, that's the bad part. Get hit, game over.
Oh, wow.
But your shield doesn't deplete there.
Yeah.
But there are those missiles.
Dang. That all or nothing, yo.
What?
Who's eating Pringles? Dang. Oh, he sucks you in there into that. Yeah, I never got to this part.
Oh my god!
Dang.
Look at all the bullets.
Yo, he's angry. He didn't have his morning coffee.
He needs to do the vaccine, boys.
Damn.
Yes, the pilot is there right now.
He's a badass, but you're a badass, total badass too by this stage, but so.
Yeah.
It's a good fight.
Man.
It's just so cinematic. It's so cool.
And that was like a thing with Ray, with like the Ray series too, is like the series had like a cinematic presentation, and whenever I look at these games, it seems like they took that nod too, with the presentation being an important part of the experience.
Oh, by the way, this is Libra. I think Siren said Virgo, but isn't this Libra,
Virgo,
right?
Sorry.
Yeah,
it's definitely Libra.
Those bones on the ground? GeoCities.
Okay, so skip the ending there, obviously, but that was the end of the game.
Alright.
And this is the intro to ALLTYNEX 2nd.
Yeah, we're actually going to watch the other ALLTYNEX vids that I linked. So, stop watching it.
That's Reflex.
Oh, that was very cool.
Yep. There's Reflex for you. Reflect them up. It's good. Another rich story. Damn, man. It gave me hope.
the replay that you guys chose didn't actually go to the very last boss, because after you defeat them, there's like another scene where I think it fast forwards and you have to fight one more boss, and there's actually Kamui ships that appear.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
So the replay that you got that I was gonna show before that one actually showed the final battle, but we chose that other video instead. But that just should motivate some people to get the game and find out what the true last boss looks like.
Indeed.
And this is in Reflex or Ultimate Second?
Ultimate Second.
Oh, okay.
About there.
No, I was talking about Reflex.
Oh, you were. Oh, my yeah. Bad. Okay.
All right.
I'm just
supposed to
get into these replays in a moment here. So talk about the basics of Ultimate Second. What's the mechanics and stuff in this game?
I'll talk to the story first, if that's okay, and then get into the nuts and bolts. So this is the final game, the most recent game to be released by Siter Skain in the series, but it's actually the first in terms of how the story progresses in the trilogy. And the background here is that the year 2142, and for the last 40 years ago, the ALLTYNEX, sort of city administrative computer, went completely rogue for reasons unknown, and took control of the Earth's drone armies, mechanized armies, and basically went on this massacring spree all over the world, trying to wipe out all humans. So I think it was the stat at the beginning of the game, it's something like within the first 24 hours, like 48 hours, 75% of the world's population had been just killed by that amount of time. 85%, sorry. Playing it down. So, basically, there's nothing people can do against this, but a small group of people managed to escape the Earth and flee to just the outer part of the solar system. So, 40 years goes by. ALLTYNEX's complete control of the Earth has wiped out all the humans there. These other humans have been living on the outer side of the solar system in really harsh conditions, and their population's been gradually going down because it's just killing them all. So they rally together and decide that they're going to try and take back the Earth. Now this is, as the game begins, you're part of this fleet of ships, of humans, that are going back to reclaim their Earth. It's like the first and last effort to try and get Earth back from this rogue AI. That kind of lines it up. In terms of mechanics, I'll hand over to someone more technical than me at the back.
All right, well, how about Softdrink, since he's here for this game?
Yeah, definitely. So ALLTYNEX Second, you have, you know, a kind of a straightforward, you know, main shot, and then you have three sub-weapons. There's a homing laser that's similar to the homing lasers in Ikaruga that kind of comes out of the back of your ship and loops around. It can hit multiple enemies. There's a sword, which is great for close range. You know, it's extremely powerful, but it's somewhat difficult to use. It can actually cancel bullets, but you can't use it constantly. It's a three slash kind of a burst, and then there's a pause, and then you can slash again. It's important to get like good positioning and timing with that and know what's going on. And then there's also like a super laser. I don't even know what to call it, but it's just like a giant laser that locks onto your current target and just like it just does crazy damage. But the main thing that makes the system kind of unique is that you have an energy gauge which fills up through five levels, and that corresponds to the power of your main shot. And whenever you use one of your special weapons, with the exception of the sword, for reasons that are a little bit difficult to explain, but whenever you use a special weapon, it depletes the main gauge. So whenever you, you know, are using a more powerful attack, your main shot gets weaker. Right. So it leaves you more open to, say, missiles. And there's a lot of parts in the game where you have to balance that fairly well. So in terms of scoring, then you have a multiplier system very similar to what you have in Einhander, where the quicker you kill, you know, small enemies, it can build up to times 16. But in order to apply the multiplier, you have to use a special weapon. So you have a dynamic in the game where you're constantly switching back and forth between using your special weapons to maximize score and play very aggressively, and simultaneously trying to keep your main shot powerful enough that you're able to survive whatever's going to come at you next.
Gotcha. That explains it pretty well. Indeed.
There's also a little bit of a kind of a chain system, if you want to call it that, where if you kill popcorn enemies in a row, you have, you know, it starts with, I think, 400 and then doubles to 800, all the way up to 25,600 points per enemy killed. And that's a kind of similar to something you see in Ikaruga. But the difference is that you have to do it really, really quickly. And so if you want to score well, you have to kind of plan your route well enough that you're, you know, moving from popcorn to popcorn and maintaining that chain.
Mm. Oh, did you mention the times 16 bar?
Yeah. Okay. I mean, it's hard to explain with just words. Once the replay starts, we'll go into it more.
Okay.
But yeah, I had some gameplay going at that time, so a lot of that probably made sense. So sounds good. But yeah, I suppose we can just get into the replay then.
Yeah, speaking of the replay, here we go.
All right. Get that ready here. All right, then yeah, part one of ALLTYNEX Second One TC. I shall do the countdown. 3, 2, 1, click.
I'll just put out the obvious and say this is the first game in the series, the only game in the series with 3D graphics. Up until now, they've been 2D. And this is Siter Skain's first ever in a 3D game.
Mmm.
It's very cool looking, I must say.
Oh, yeah.
I love this opening scene because it's like, it's kind of an inversion of the, like I was saying earlier, of you know, these kind of battleship raid sequences you see a lot in shmups where it's like one ship against this whole army. Here, you're clearly just one guy as part of this enormous fleet, and then you get to watch as all of your comrades get destroyed fighting against the enemy. So I just think that's really cool.
Not that they're getting destroyed, but that you're part of the fleet.
Yeah, yeah, but that you get that sense of being part of something so much bigger than yourself.
It reminds me of when we covered Strania. Oh, there's the two sides that you play as. So it kind of gives you that perspective.
So if you're kind of watching how this is going, lower left-hand corner is the energy bar, upper right is the combo meter, and then as he's killing enemies, it's bringing up these little, you know, point totals above them. So it's kind of, do you get a sense for what I was trying to explain earlier?
Yeah, definitely.
This is actually captured from replay file as well. You can tell because the logo is in the bottom right. Normally that isn't there when you play the game. There is a replay mode in the game, and it has a really fun cinematic view as well, which is it's fun to play around and switch through that because it changes up the viewpoint.
Oh, wow.
In front of the ship.
Oh.
Yeah,
that's really neat.
Now that's an added thing I haven't seen before.
Yeah, I think this replay has two or three instances where they go into that mode.
And you actually play.
The sword action reminds me of my beloved Milestone games, you know, like Chaos Field and... I love the swords.
Yeah, I can get that sword. Thing. So one thing you're going to see a lot of in this replay, probably, I haven't watched all the way through it, is quick killing things to try and get them while they're still under effect of the combo meter. So like, you know, you build up your multiplier with popcorn, and then you try to cash in by killing bosses or large enemies very quickly because they're worth more points. And so that was why you saw that first mid-boss. He just rushed up there and killed him instantly.
Because his combo meter was high.
Yeah, because his combo meter was still at, like, times 11 or something at that point. So.
Okay.
So you chain the values, and then there's also the multiplier.
Yeah.
Both of those things.
He doesn't do it here, but you can do it here as well.
Guys, if you check out, the game is really focused on high speed. It's all pull the sword, slash, throw missiles, build up that multiplier, keep it up, and blast away. It's all like hyper super speed action.
Yeah, it's really aggressive. Love that. It's very fun to play.
It's very aggressive. You sit down, have the dose of action, and blast away. Sorry, I love it too. I love all three games.
I actually haven't cleared this yet. I've made it to the second to last boss on one credit, but
stage
we have
three,
a question from the chat from Squire Grooktook. He says, is there any limit to how much you can cancel bullets with the sword, or can you just mash to be safe in the fight?
The sword it kind of has like a burst thing, so you do three slashes and then there's a pause and you're vulnerable during the pause, and then you do three more slashes, and there's also some things you can't cancel. So for example, there's certain types of bullets that you won't be able to destroy, and I'll point those out when it comes to them. You can't destroy any kind of lasers, large or small. Oh, that's cool. Is that the replay cam? Yeah, that's awesome.
Oh, yeah.
That's awesome. But there's a lot of things that prevent you from just mashing it, but there are certain places in the game where you can literally just go up and like mash the B button.
Stage 2
and,
boss.
Yeah.
Stage 2. The low swording.
Yeah. It's, yeah.
It's a really nice feature. I love the kind of close and personal melee mechanic. It makes you not hug the bottom of the screen.
Yeah, definitely.
I want to point out that in this mid-boss you could destroy the tips of the wounds before getting rid of the main body, but you gotta do it fairly quickly because you do get off of the screen pretty quickly.
And you can also once you kill the first one, popcorn will start appearing, and so you can then build up your multiplier so you can cash in on the second one. I love this part.
Of course, missiles. Missiles everywhere. Don't you just love Itano Circus?
One thing I really like about this game is it just makes you feel like a total badass. It's just like, you know, there's all these missiles coming your way, just shoot them down. You know, giant base. You know, I'm just gonna blow this up. It's great.
Oh yeah, your laser, it's called Aston Rifle.
Ah, okay. Thank you.
Those little green lights, you could have hit that with the sword, which you will.
Yeah, I don't think those ones are destructible yet.
The first one you could run up to it and hit it.
Oh, really? Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, I've done it. That.
That's very cool.
A little serpent, right? I just love how the music synchronizes with the action.
This always reminds me of R-Type a little bit, because you have the same kind of, you know, like very environmental enemies a lot in R-Type and a lot of serpent imagery, so I thought that was kind of a cool little shout out there.
Oh man, here it is again.
It's also important to position yourself so that the snake goes around you and blocks those lasers, because towards the end of slashing them they kind of get fast, and if you don't have it the serpent in front of you, you might get hit.
Yeah definitely. The first few times I played this level, I just got destroyed at that section because it's, yeah.
And then game stage 3, oh god. That boss.
The stage 3 boss.
You can also get hit by that rotating,
The arm.
Yeah,
the
you arm. Can get hit by that. It's a mess.
It's so frustrating when that happens because you're just like, what? What hit me? What hit me?
Yeah, thank god you had the defense field, but it just takes one hit then. Boom.
Oh, you could get an accomplishment on this boss by not destroying it quickly, and it hits you with a big laser, basically. You get achievement.
Yeah.
Achievement unlocked. get owned by the laser.
That happened to me like 3 times when I was trying to play this, man. And like, if you get hit by it, like, it just ends your game, I think, right?
Yeah, I think it's instant game over.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, no, man. Continues. Game over, bitch.
It's like, you're done, idiot.
Laser.
It happened to me three times. I didn't know what the hell was going
get
on.
Get out of here.
Oh, this one is an asshole, Donnie.
Yeah, so.
Normally, I just run up to him and sword him right away.
Save
you can kill him
grief.
Pretty quick.
Well, the popcorn enemies give you a little more.
That's true, though.
So, some of the other achievements that you get is the 1060 multiplier, the 10 times the
perspective
25,000. So, that's the popcorn.
I wish you could play the game in the replay camera the whole time.
Yeah.
Actually, there are some dynamic angles in a few places in the game. Reminds me a lot of Eschatos for that reason. So you'll see that a little bit later on.
That's what I was reading off.
It's like the windshield wiper.
There's actually two different ships too. There's an advanced type ship which is a little different. It has a slightly different like button configuration. The special weapons are triggered in different ways, and it has missiles instead of the weird homing laser things. I haven't played around with it very much.
Bullets.
Man, that replay camera is a neat idea. Still can't get over it. Oh yeah, this part reminds me of Gradius 5.
You
first stage
go
boss.
Up there and just sword it the whole time. And it rotates with it. So
you can actually, if you have full meter, you can just laser it from the moment it starts being vulnerable, and you'll kill it before it has a chance to fire.
Oh, man.
Oh, yeah.
All right, part two. You guys ready?
Looks like it's already going.
Oh, wait.
Oh, it is for me.
You're in the playlist. I didn't mean to link the playlist. Well, if you guys could go to part two.
Okay.
At the zero. You all good?
Oh, Traps asking how player rotation works. You don't have any real control over it. It kind of automatically locks onto whatever you're shooting at the time, especially with the larger laser cannon. So, and then it stays that way while you're holding down the laser to fire. Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt the countdown. My bad.
Oh, that's fine. We all good on that? Sion stepped away.
Can you guys still hear me? You have a ship that has free rotation mode. You can unlock it by clearing the game.
Oh, really? That's cool.
There is a second ship available, yes. And it has a... It's called the Advanced Model, Advanced Type. I can't remember the name. But, yes, there is a second ship.
Can you guys still hear me?
Yep.
Yes.
Okay. Alright, well, we all ready then?
Yeah.
Yes? Okay. Alright.
Yep.
Part 2. 3... 2, 1, click. Mine was a little delayed, but whatever.
Did you guys hear when I read out the achievement list?
No. I think you broke up there.
Okay, so some of the achievement lists, some of the achievements that I got was a times 60 multiplier, a 10 times the 25,600 in the combo, and then finish normal, finish hard, and die from the big laser cannon.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Everyone got that, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
All 3 Altynex games are for PC. Windows PC, I mean. Yes, it will be for direct sales, Desura, I think Rise Digital and Gamersgate, all DRM-free. And we will submit it for Steam Greenlight.
Awesome.
Excellent.
There is also there is achievements for every game. No, the last one only has them. If we get to Steam, we could probably ask Ichirun to add achievements to all three games. That would be superb. I would love to do that, but of course, Steam Greenlight first. Yeah. So, there is one thing I love about this game is that it doesn't need over, you know, flashy graphics and stuff. It keeps up such a great direction, action, enemy wave placement, enemy movement, how the ships bank and fire, all that stuff. It's, you know, yeah. This guy knows his shit. Yeah, period.
I like the little touches too. Like you do a barrel roll when you change directions really quickly. Just kind of fun.
Or the small trail when you're moving fast.
Yeah.
Does that have an effect on gameplay?
No. It's not like Air Garrett or Air Gallet or whatever the official title is. It's not like that where you can dodge more quickly when that happens.
Akugale,
okay.
Lose your socks off.
What the hell was that?
I think you have to hold a direction for like a second, right? Before you could do a barrel roll in the other direction.
Something like that, yeah.
In this or in...
In this one, yeah.
I mean, it doesn't really have an effect on gameplay that I can tell, so it doesn't matter.
No, it's sort of flashing giggles and shit, yeah.
Yeah.
You gotta get
but it rocks, of course it rocks.
It blows my socks off!
Yeah, Alpha Prospector,
there we go, baby!
If you play Air Gallet, it says, they actually say it blows your socks off in the intro of the game. There's like a woman that says that.
Blows your socks off!
Yeah, it's really funny.
The best thing.
Play Air Gallet only for that reason.
You know, like those AT ads, you know, those that narrator that keeps saying, you got to go buy that toy, it's fucking awesome, go buy it. Yeah, like that.
Well, I was playing Donpachi recently, and man, the narrator in that game.
Yeah.
The narrator is hilarious.
It's great, we need more narrators like that.
Yeah.
True.
Really. You
keep
got it!
Finger on the trigger, rookie!
Yeah, there we go.
Who is the voice actor for that?
I think they pick some gaijin up in the bar and is like, we need you. It's like, you got it, kid!
God.
Oh, man. Oh, so this boss is really annoying. This form of it's not too bad.
Everyone
but
gets a game over here.
Yeah, it drops the little mines on the sides, and those can totally kill you if you're not paying attention. They have these little purple explosions, and it's just like, what? What was that? Because they look like background items, but they can definitely... They're very lethal. And then this form of it, those laser cannons on the side keep respawning, so you can make it safe for yourself for a little while, but then they'll come back by the time he's done with this missile barrage attack. So it's just very tricky to kind of manage him because of the way that his attack patterns work.
There's a video on Nico that there's a guy showing, you know, how you could pretty much milk those for a while.
Yeah, I'm sure you can.
They are so annoying. I hate them.
I usually just go for a quick kill here because I tend to lose a life to it.
Yeah. Fire the busted rifle, burn the beach.
Nice explosion. Off screen, but still good. Now loading.
All right. I love this stage. So cool.
Yeah, it's really fast. It's a great sense of motion for it.
Fast defense line.
I think in one of the demos, it showed the actual explosion of that in the background. I don't know.
Oh. Sword that
sword that big enemy.
Okay. This is really plush, by the way.
Yeah. See, I've hit the 2-hour mark for the stream, by the way. Longest episode ever.
Yeah, it's the epic tale of ALLTYNEX.
Takes a while to tell that tale.
Yeah, yeah. Come down and sit and hear a tale. A tale of a fateful trip. Where we play all the shoot-em-ups. The tales of ALLTYNEX.
Why?
Oh, that's cool.
Because
in the normal game, it does a weird little like chase cam thing where you see those flying overhead as they drop the tanks off. But here, you just saw it like that. It was kind of neat.
Gosh, look how fast they're all moving! Look at the speed.
Yeah, oh,
I love this.
60 FPS.
Yeah, man. Fuck, look at this.
No, 30
I could just walk. A
quick note here: if you don't quick kill those guys, they do this kind of like streamed shot where they move up towards the center of the screen. It's easy to intercept with the sword, but it gets very annoying if you don't manage it correctly. And also this, this mid boss can be really tricky. Those things don't want to die. They look like they do, but they really don't. So when you're playing like
Matrix mode.
Oh dang, cinematic scene.
When I was playing Jenga Force, it goes. There's a part where there's these things that come down that look similar to that. Has anyone played Jenga Force?
Yeah, yeah, I know. I think I know what you're talking about.
Yeah. Like these police scouters.
The
or
lights,
something.
Yeah, the lights.
Yeah.
I still haven't played that. Is it good?
It's really good.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, Cute is really coming.
I think it's actually better than the first. So.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Yeah, guys, go run out and get Ginga Force.
Oh, for sure.
You have it all
there.
I mean,
yeah, speaking of, like, awesome 3D... like perspective changes in the game and everything. I mean, everyone's got it too. Seems to be like kind of a fad with the 3D shmups now. It's just having a little bit of perspective changes. I mean, I've seen it in Aether Vapor Remaster, this game, you know, Eschatos and Ginga Force. I mean, even in the other Siter Skain games, those like the background enemies and stuff that shot the bullets into the foreground. Seems to be like a thing. I guess it like makes it more immersive because it's like you kind of get a feel like there's more to like just that one play field. It's like the one plane, like you got stuff coming from like the distance and stuff like that. Oh man, this boss is trying to poke your eye out.
Shoot your eye out! Shoot your eye out!
I don't remember the boss doing that, actually. Maybe the patch made it do that?
If you destroy the things really quickly, like if you laser them right away, they don't do that.
Oh, okay.
So that might have been what happened. I don't know what your strategy is for this guy.
Yeah, I think that's what I did. Just run up there.
Kill the asshole fast. That's my strategy with all bosses.
Yeah.
Kill them fast.
Yeah, to be honest, I'm a little surprised that...
Echoes of the Kamui boss, right?
Yeah, yeah.
That's the boss theme.
I think I mentioned that earlier. Yeah. And there's a couple others you'll probably recognize in the next stage as well. So, trying to figure out if there's any advantage to fighting the boss the long way like this. Rather than quick killing it.
I guess you get some shot points.
That's true. No.
They're very little though.
This, yeah, you just quick kill this with the sword.
I thought the health bar goes down so much from the swords.
Yeah, the sword is really, really powerful.
It's like, damn. That's a lightsaber, yo.
So, if there were a battle between all three ships, who would you go for?
You
mean, of the series.
You mean the player ships?
Yeah.
I don't know, man. I'll go with the Reflex ship.
I like to go Kamui. Because there's I'll a chick Kamui. Inside there. And it, even though that there's like, it's just a girl's brain, she's probably hot still. With those lobes.
Like,
check
yeah.
out the lobes on Alice.
Okay, we are entering Toho territory. Oh god.
There's just something about a smooth young brain.
Zombie in the house.
This is not a zombie shmup. Go play your Plants versus Flowers.
Oh, that camera's really cool. That just yeah. the angles that it comes up with. That's neat.
Is Sion still there?
Yeah, I just jumped back on again.
Okay.
What news do you have of the Final Apocalypse?
Not a lot of new news, not since C83 when the last demo came out. But I believe this one's I've been kind of on and off following. There is a blog, a development blog by Jiriran, and we can add the link to it to the comments for this afterwards. And that'll give an update on what he's been doing there. But I believe that the Bit Summit event kind of slowed things down for a little while, but still ongoing. From what I've seen so far and from what I understand, the story has nothing to do with the ALLTYNEX universe. It's a completely standalone game. And it's got a pretty different style of play, as you've seen with the kind of free roaming aspect to it.
And yeah, of course, Final Apocalypse is the next Siter Skain game coming up.
Oh, before AlphaProspector corrects me as well, that was actually the working title for it, and the English title for it, the official title for it now is, in English, Heavy Dragoon Dragons.
Drug?
Ooh.
Wait, what's the last word?
Dragon.
Yes. It has robots and ships and stuff.
Hmm.
Dragoons are cool. Alright, well, so we got one last part for ALLTYNEX second, part 3. Then we can wrap up the episode. It's been really damn long. Past 2 hours here. So yeah, part 3. You guys ready? Do it up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right, let's do it up. Finish this up. 3, 2, 1, click.
Aggressive attack.
So there's some really annoying enemies in the opening of this stage. I'll point them out when they come. But it's very important to deal with them properly or they will just murder you. These guys here, what happens is they shoot a few waves of bullets, but they also drop little mines, and those have purple explosions that are persistent. So they'll just chill out on the screen for like, you know, 20 seconds or whatever. And it gets really frustrating because it can totally wreck your movement. So
yeah, the homing laser is definitely your friend on this stage.
And might recognize this guy.
Libra.
Was this the, a Kamui boss?
Or... I think this was the Reflex end boss.
Oh, okay. Whoa!
Warning, warning.
I always wonder if that's a shout out to Metroid, but I can't tell. No. Mother Brain.
Yeah.
Let's just say it is.
Let's talk
about it. Ah, Yakamino, it's here. He's saying that's the Zodiac husk. It's like the shell, it doesn't have the Zodiac core inside.
I was just about to jump in with that. I was just doing some quick fact checking. So, I mentioned that the craft in Reflex has the Ephusius core on it. That's just the core of the Ephusius Zodiac. The actual main body of the Ephusius Zodiac was the one that just saw.
Oh, whoa. Okay. But
it didn't have the core in it, which is why it's kind of underpowered compared to people. Mm. But otherwise, it would be probably powerful with people.
Just swording it.
It's the LOL sorting.
It's like an egg, you have to crack all the shells to get to the gooey center.
The gooey center.
Shoot the core, guys.
Shoot the core. Oh, we
get core.
Damn, man.
Ooh.
Or sword like the core, as the case may be.
Absolutely, this. Oh, dang!
I'm gonna give away some more story elements. We need to add some pretty heavy spoiler warnings to this before it goes on YouTube. So, what's happening now is ALLTYNEX has been destroyed, but being destroyed, it's opening a rift to another dimension. And another ship from that other ship from that other dimension is coming out. So it's like a last ditch attempt to just try and destroy your ship. As you'll see, it's got the energy wings that the Zodiacs have as well. So it's uber powerful. And this is the true final boss for this game.
Whoa.
More spoilerage while watching here. So the game's called ALLTYNEX Second, which kind of has a double meaning. This is a remake of the FM Towns version from 96. So in that sense, it's ALLTYNEX Second. But ALLTYNEX Second is the designation of the ALLTYNEX AI that you kill as the prior boss here. And it's kind of left as a mystery in the ending of the game. But the reason that it's called ALLTYNEX Second, despite the fact that it's the only ALLTYNEX in existence, is because I'm just trying to think the right way to explain this. There are several ALLTYNEXes in existence, but only in the sense that they exist in different dimensions. So what happened was the group that actually engineered ALLTYNEX going rogue in the first place did so by tapping into all of these other ALLTYNEXes in different dimensions, kind of creating a serial processing loop out of them so they could generate enough processing power for it to go rogue at the level of sentience that it did in this game. So as they opened up these other dimensions, they happened to designate the ALLTYNEX computer in our second, and that's the reason why it's called second, despite the fact that it's only one ALLTYNEX. Pretty badass story setting.
Yeah, that's very cool.
Yeah, man.
for the final boss, right?
It looks like the final boss, I mean, a boss that you battle in Kamui, right? Is it the same one?
It's not the same one. It's from a different dimension, but it has the energy wings that's kind of the signature visual characteristic of all the original Zodiac machines.
Okay. Mm.
Gosh.
That's so why it's called Visitor Flunky Foth.
You can get a pretty decent quick kill going here if you get up close and sword during this laser attack. It's not immediate, like you have to go through two rounds of the attack, but it goes a lot faster than what this guy's doing.
Ooh.
Yeah, you could like your friend would come over and be like, "Hey, check out this game, this awesome replay." And like you could say like, "Oh, that was me playing during that." They like, no,
yeah,
they don't know.
You can change all
the
angles.
Like, how the hell did you do that?
And you're like, and then I had to switch behind and. Oh, look at this!
All right, game over. Game over.
Game over. Oh, that was really cool.
No ending because it was a replay.
Hmm. So you guys got to play it for the ending.
Yep. Well, I mean, certainly the biggest thing I kind of noticed was that these games have a very, very deep story. I mean, there's definitely a lot going on. We got a lot of it explained, but man, it just really makes me look forward to these localizations from Nyu Media, because I feel like if I knew everything, like when I'm playing it, like it might, you know, kind of take on that existential kind of feeling. And then, you know, I'd be having a...
That's the Karua feel, right?
I'd be having like a pseudo LSD trip at the same time. And then I would become one with my arcade controller. So...
Yeah.
Yeah.
And don't let me have a winner here.
You really have to really enjoy the games. You got to know the backstory and see, appreciate what's happening from element to element. You don't have to, but it really does add a lot to them.
Yeah, it seems like, you know, that's an aspect that is there, and it can be appreciated. So, you know, a lot of times it's like, there usually is like a story in the various shooting games and stuff, but like, you know, some of them are kind of throwaway, like just X World War II setting or whatever. But then others really have like kind of some intricate things that, you know, relate to all the bosses and pretty much everything that you do. And I think this is one of those games, game series where everything kind of ties in with each other. And
you can probably, and you can really see it helps to know the story because you can see the citations of each in each game as it follows in and. Yeah.
Definitely a lot to be a fan of, I guess.
Yeah, we just touched on some of the main elements as well today. There are other more subtle nuances to it. Like, probably most people wouldn't notice that there is another ship that escapes at the beginning of Reflex, which is kind of the Mark 1 version of your ship, and that has just a little bit of a story going to it, too. So, you know, as much as you dig, you'll pretty much keep on finding stuff for a good while in these games.
Yeah, that's awesome. I'm looking forward to the translated version, so can't wait.
Thanks. Likewise, can't wait to bring it out. So end of May is the release. We haven't announced the day yet, but it will be the end of May for all three games together. They'll be available on a standalone basis. They'll be available as a bundle. The soundtracks will be coming out too. It will be going on to Steam Greenlight. And we have, just to recap, a big announcement on Tuesday about the series and the release. And so please keep an eye on our Facebook, the Nyu Media Facebook, Twitter, and our forums, if you're on our forums too.
Yeah, and we'll get all those links in the YouTube description as well to, you know, get that out there. So.
Oh, promoting? Yeah, definitely. And we'd love to have you back on for other Nyu Media games. Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. We'd love to come back. We've got, Aether Vapor Remaster. We have the Exceed series.
Satasius, of course.
Satasius is love. Yeah.
Yeah.
And we'd be happy to come back again.
Cool. Excellent. All right. Thanks for coming on, Tian.
Cheers, guys. Cheers. And thanks to everyone for watching, of course. Please buy the games when they come out.
Yes. Buy all the games.
From Steam Greenlight as well.
Support the Shamak Mugs. Yeah. Or Shamap, I don't know how. SDGs. Shoot them ups.
That damn term, man. It's going to haunt us forever.
Yeah. That damn schmuck muck mup.
Schmuck mup.
For schmucks. Yeah.
For schmucks.
So, Aqua. Aqua.
Chumps.
All right. And then also, thanks, Alpha Prospector as well. And Softdrink.
Welcome.
Softdrink and Aleksei. You guys really helped
out. Last but not least, Aleksei. Thanks for coming on, man.
Hey, Aqua. Thank you for having me, guys.
Oh, we got a question. What?
How long is the video now?
It's 2 hours and 21 minutes.
Yeah.
29.
Set a record.
Oh, yeah.
Is that a record?
20.
It's a record. 30, yeah. This is a long episode.
32.
33. But hey.
Okay, we'll probably try to put some timestamps on the link. So.
That'd probably be good too for when each game starts. Perhaps people can.
Yeah. People that way you can watch this thing in like a little mini episode. Yeah. So.
All right. Well, I think that'll do it. It's been so long. It's been long enough. What are we thinking of next week? What was it?
We might what?
Oh yeah, it might be Battle was Grega it? Next week. Might be.
Battle Grega, guys. Oh, you asked for it. They're coming with it.
That rank. Oh my god.
Yeah, so we're really going to try to do it up. You know, we're going to have a lot of experts. Great replay for you guys.
That's going to be amazing.
Did anyone download the Super Play with the Golden Bat before it got into private?
Oh, you mean, Kamui's?
I think Kamui's is with Gain.
Oh, yeah, okay.
That's with Gain, but. There was one it's on Shmup's forum that somebody started a forum saying that there was a really good super play with the Golden Bat,
yeah.
But it got turned into private, so only up to level 6 got downloaded. So I was wondering if anyone had the full version, because it's actually as good as Kamui's replay.
Oh,
wait, really? That would be something to see.
Yeah, I guess we'll post it and field the question if anyone downloaded. Who was the player? Was it Ket or K-E-T or?
I don't know, because it cuts off after stage 6, so I can't see the initial input.
Okay. All right, we'll take a look. We'll do some hunting.
Right, so that may be next week.
Yeah. And then, you know, we've been thinking about like Shmups 101. We've got all these other neat things going on. We might highlight Nordy Games Chrono Blast, you know, maybe make a developer episode. Mm-hmm. So have the developer on and talk about their game and maybe some programming and whatnot and what goes into programming a shmup.
That'd be really interesting.
Rest.
But yeah.
So yeah, got lots of stuff in store for you guys.
Indeed. So yep, that'll wrap up STG Weekly number 17. Thank you everyone for watching and see you next week.
See you next week.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye, everyone. Thanks.
Yeah!
Good job.